Welcome to Excel Crafters, the Microsoft Excel tutorial channel. This is a quick video on how you can enable buttons in Excel. Let's get started. So the first thing that we have to do is write a macro, because once you create a button, you have to link it to a macro to perform some action. So what you have to do is go to Developer tab and click on Visual Basic. Now, if you do not have the Developer tab in your version of Excel right now, I have a video that explains how to bring in the Developer tab in your ribbon. I will link it here. You can go ahead and check that out. So once you have the Developer tab in your ribbon, go to Visual Basic. Next, we have to go ahead and insert a module. Right, so let's start with the coding part. Once this macro is called, it'll just show an alert box with the text Hello World. The macro part is done. Let's see how we can add a button. There are multiple ways of doing this. One of the methods is to use a shape. So you can pick a rectangle and you can choose whatever color you want. You can, you know, give effects to it so that it looks like a button. Next, let us see how we can add a button label. Right click on the button, click on edit text, and you can type in click me. Okay, the text has come here, but it is not properly aligned, right? We want it in the middle. So what you need to do is right click, format shape, and if you go to the shape option, you can see the text box vertical alignment. It is given as top. Change it to middle. The next thing you have to do is link it to the macro that we have created. If you right click and assign macro, you can see the macro that we wrote initially is now available here. You just have to select it and click OK. Now if you see, when we mouse over to this button, it automatically changes to a clickable cursor. Now, in case you want to change some more properties at this point, what you need to do is just hold on the Ctrl key. It will change it to the option where you can select the button. Or else what will happen is it will directly click the button and the macro will get executed. We will go ahead and click the button and see what happens. You can see that the alert box with the text Hello World has come up here. And that's how a button is implemented using shapes. A second option that we can use is if you go to Developer and go into Insert, and you can see the form controls, and this is a button inside form control. So you have to drag to the size that you want, and you can directly assign the macro. Again, let's assign it to Hello World. Click OK. You can definitely change the text in this button. So let's change it to click me again. If you want to edit something in this button or select this button, you have to key press Ctrl and then click it. And if you want to directly activate the button, just click on it. And you can see the same behavior. Hello World alert box has come. There is another method, which is the ActiveX control. I don't prefer using that, because there were cases earlier that an Office update or a Windows update has broken the functionalities of ActiveX controls. It's better to stay away from that when you have better options like these. So I'm not going through that option at all here. But in case you have any queries regarding that, just let me know over comments and we can initiate a discussion in the comment section. That was all for this video. Hope you learned how to create buttons and assign it to a macro. Let me know if you have any further comments or queries on the same. That's it for today. Until next time, bye-bye.